One flag had been captured south of the river, but on the other side, the North Vietnamese flag proudly flew above the ancient citadel, a reminder that the battle for Hue was far from over. Since their forced retreat on the first day of battle, the Marines knew they would need to return and recapture it. Whoever controlled the citadel controlled the city. To slow down the advancing Marines, the NVA blew up the bridge over the river, forcing the Marines to set off in landing craft known as LCUs. Lieutenant Nick War of 1st Battalion, 5th Marines, had arrived in Hue 24 hours previously and was now on board one of the boats.
I can remember thinking, even at a distance, this fortress was massive. The most unforgettable sight is seeing that huge NVA flag flying from the top of the flag tower on the citadel. It was hard to believe that that's basically where we were going.
13 days earlier, the US Marines had been forced to retreat from the citadel by a huge NVA onslaught. This time, they were determined to arrive fully prepared for anything the NVA could throw at them.
They had first loaded the LCUs almost to the gunnels with high explosive ammunition and mortar rounds and rocket rounds, and we were sitting on top of all of that.
Halfway across the river, the landing craft were spotted by the enemy.
As we moved downstream, we all of a sudden heard an enemy 60-millimeter mortar round hit its tube. We knew exactly what that meant. The first round hit on one side, the other round hit on the opposite side. Now they have us bracketed. It's simply a matter of making an adjustment and continuing to shoot rounds at us, and eventually they're going to hit us, and if they hit us, we're all dead. Our guys started raking the riverbank with 50 caliber machine gun fire. During that entire time, nobody said a word. We all just were praying, because it was definitely a pucker factor moment. But fortunately for us, the machine gunners on that LCU craft chased them away.
Narrowly escaping, the Marines made it safely across the river. Once there, they met up with their South Vietnamese allies in the northeast corner of the citadel. The street, which was codenamed Phase Line Green, was directly in the line of fire of one of the strongest NVA positions, the Dong Ba Tower. This imposing structure on the citadel's east wall gave the enemy a great vantage point from which to fire on the Marines as they tried to cross that line.
They had the high ground, and they had these machine guns and automatic weapons just raking the street right down on us. From the amount of gunfire I was receiving, I knew that there were an awful lot of enemy.
On the 14th of February, 1968, day two of the attack on the citadel, the rules of engagement were lifted, giving the option of heavy weapons and aircraft bombing. Captain Myron Harrington was in command of Delta Company, 1st Battalion, 5th Marines, and was under orders to capture the Dong Ba Tower.
They said, we're going to put a heavy concentration of artillery and naval gunfire on the tower and the area surrounding it. I'm thinking, well, you know, if I'm really lucky, they will obliterate the target, kill all the NVA, and all we'll have to do is go and take up ground on the tower.
On the 15th of February, the tower was bombarded with artillery fire, silencing the NVA guns.
We could hear heavy weapons being used north of us and south of us, and it was constant. So this was a whole different dynamic. So we knew that this was different. This was pretty much all-out war now.
As we moved out of our covered position onto the street, we were receiving absolutely no fire. So there was the thought that the artillery and naval gunfire had done what they were supposed to do, and the NVA had evacuated the area.
But there were still huge numbers of fighters hiding in the city. And to the surprise of the Marines, they regrouped to launch a vigorous defense of the tower.
The tower to me was very imposing, very formidable, very intimidating. And going through my mind was, how in the hell are we going to do this?
Even with heavy artillery and naval gunfire at their disposal, the Marines needed to come up with a new strategy to take the tower. They organized specialist teams using a combination of weaponry.
The most effective supporting arms through the whole rest of the battle were what we called killer teams, which was an M48 tank paired up with an Ontos.
The Ontos is a lightweight American armored anti-tank vehicle. It has 6 106 recoilless rifles and a range of 3,500 yards. Its mobility makes it less vulnerable than a tank and highly effective for ground bombardment. The killer teams made an immediate impact on the tower, but the battle was not yet won. Even after demolishing the structure, Marines still had to physically take the high ground.
It became a pile of rubble. And those guys would have to climb up that pile and, you know, work their way up. They were hit several times with direct strikes from 250-pound and 500-pound bombs and napalm. Eventually, the Marines had to take that by force with a frontal assault.
The Marines finally took the Dong Ba Tower.
We, at this point, had fire superiority, and we had obtained the battalion objective, and we'd secured the tower.
Once the tower was taken, the NVA realized that they were now in an untenuous position because we could start flanking them, and they pulled back.
On February the 24th, after nearly 4 weeks of fighting, the citadel fell and the South Vietnamese flag was raised over Hue.
We're kind of elated that we had done the job that we were supposed to do. That's one of the amazing things to me. With all the restrictions that were placed on us, we were still able to win that battle.
But victory came at a price. For the Marines, it was the bloodiest battle of the war. 142 men were killed in action, 857 wounded.
I saw more death and destruction in Hue City in that 24 days than I saw on my entire tour.
He had us outnumbered 10 to 1. There was going to be a lot of casualties on both sides, luckily more of them than us.
There were over 5,000 enemy killed in the battle for Hue. The troops that were sent into Hue were destroyed. This was the signature victory for both South Vietnam and the US Marines.
The Battle of Hue was the Marines' toughest test in Vietnam, and they rose to the challenge. In a daring counterattack, they struck a devastating blow to the NVA, forcing them to retreat. The conflict has gone down in American history as one of the most hard-fought battles of the entire war.
That 1 month was something that will live with me forever. My license plate on my car says Hue vet. I mean, I'm extremely proud of being a Hue City vet.
We will always remember those gentle heroes that paid the ultimate sacrifice and remain, for lack of a better term, forever young.